Yes, it is a new era and there is a lot happening as we go to air this morning, starting with that breaking news. Scott Morrison has just left Kirribilli House. We saw him driving out of there a few moments ago along with Jenny and his mother. While it's not clear where he's travelling, although Charles, your bet is on church, it is the first time we've seen him since conceding the election to Anthony Albanese last night, set to be sworn in as the 31st Prime Minister of Australia tomorrow, marking Labor's first return to power in nearly 9 years. Massive gains in Victoria and Western Australia got Labor over the line, securing marginal seats as well as some surprise Liberal strongholds.
Let's take a look at the race to 76. Nine News has Labor currently holding 71 seats, that is five short of the majority government they would form with 76. We are, however, yet to call 13. Key battlegrounds, and there has been an historic shift against both major parties. Primary votes at record lows for Labor and the Coalition. The Teals and other independents have taken 10 seats across the country so far. The majority of those have gone to women, while the Greens are celebrating their best ever result in an Australian election. They are on track to hold four seats in the lower house.
For the outgoing Prime Minister Scott Morrison, he says he will step down as leader of the Liberal Party but has vowed to remain in Parliament. Attention now turning to who will replace him. Defence Minister Peter Dutton shaping up as the most likely candidate to be opposition leader to Anthony Albanese's Prime Minister.
Please welcome to the stage the man set to be the 31st Prime Minister of Australia.
The son of a single mum who grew up in social housing in Sydney. Who dared to dream.
Power, power, power. OK. Power, power, power. Thank you. And I say to my fellow Australians, thank you for this extraordinary honour. My mother dreamt of a better life for me, and I hope that my journey in life inspires Australians to reach for the stars.
Backtrack 5 hours earlier. The race to 76 began as a marathon, not a sprint. Scott Morrison staring down a goat track.
Well, this time the goat has got two legs, is heading uphill on a pogo stick, because I genuinely do think that this time it is one mountain too far for the goat.
And very early on, one black sheep was out in the cold.
He once held the seat of Hughes, but no longer. We bid adieu to Craig Kelly.
Let's all strum our imaginative ukuleles as he goes. 3, 2, 1.
This has got a great ending.
Bon voyage, Punchline. Craig Kelly.
See ya.
Hi, Craig.
Immediately, there were celebrations.
Allegra, she's not in the building yet. I mean, imagine what it's going to be like when she does get here.
Shocks.
Christina Keneally is in trouble.
It got snaky.
Simon, it was pretty disgraceful behaviour. I hope it took some paint off your celebrations tonight.
Well, looking forward to getting your full apology. Thanks, Jane.
Stick it up your jumper.
Sarcastic.
Okay. Well, my name is Genghis Khan and I'm voting for the Communist Party. Good night.
Some a little sad.
Barney. Hey, Barney, just one smile, please.
But it was clear from the get-go one giant slapdown for both parties was coming.
With 1 million votes counted around Australia at the moment, both major parties are losing ground.
I recognise there is no such thing as a safe seat in this nation anymore.
Yeah. Clearly, we all need to do better.
At party HQs, the faithful knew it.
Look, it's a bit of a down mood.
We haven't seen any of the pre-polls yet. That'll be a big dump of votes that'll come later in the night.
Much rather be in our shoes than in Scott Morrison's shoes at this time of the evening.
The Teals had blue ribbon Liberals left seeing red.
Very, very easily. So we give the seat of Wentworth.
Celebrations in Bondi.
And another seat goes Teal, this time the seat of McKellar. Okay. And so we give the seat of North Sydney to the Teals.
So have you claimed the seat? Are you happy to say that you are confident that you are in?
I hope so. I think it's been declared in a few different places, so yes, let's take it.
The communities are saying you do not own a seat. It is not yours by right.
Josh Frydenberg looks very much like he is gone.
It's mathematically possible that we win in Kooyong. It's definitely difficult.
So, Dave Sharma, how much is this Scott Morrison's personal responsibility?
Are there things he's done that I disagree with? Yes. It would be false and a little facile to ascribe it to any one individual.
All eyes turned west, they turned away from the government in droves, and 3.5 hours into counting, the experts called it.
Nine is projecting a Labor Party victory.
Word quickly spread.
Our vote!
Bags were packed.
Gladys Lou, gone. Trent Zimmerman also is leaving federal parliament.
This is heartbreaking.
For now, Terry, it's off to Cuba. All right. Have fun there. Thank you, Terry. All right, we are going to do Wentworth. Would someone like to do the honours with
Dave
Sharma?
And then the main event.
Tonight, I've spoken to the Leader of the Opposition and the incoming Prime Minister, Anthony Albanese, and I've congratulated him on his election victory this evening.
The country's old boss laid on his sword as the new one laid down the law.
My fellow Australians, I think they've got the name by now. I think they got that. I know at the beginning of the campaign they said people didn't know me, but I reckon they've got it. Down. 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 No. No. Can we have order, please? Can we have a bit of order? I intend to run an orderly government and it starts here, so behave.
It was a night of commiserations.
Well, I salute Scott Morrison. I salute Josh Frydenberg.
And celebrations, but it's today that the real job begins.
A better future for all Australians. Thank you very much.